Okay, so welcome to the second lecture of the series Unreal Engine 5 for Archviz. In the previous video, we modeled these walls, and in today's video, we will model the windows of this living room and the windows of the bedroom. Okay, so let's get started. I will go into the top view and I will bring in a single vertex. And I will place this vertex right here, extrude and snap. Let's create another single vertex. Let's create a copy, Shift D on X-axis and snap. Let's press Shift D again and snap. Okay, so let me enable the locking. I will lock this curve. And now I will select my meshes. Okay, so now I have selected all of these and I will go into edit mode. I will select all the vertices, extrude in Z direction up to this wall. Okay. Okay, now I will model this wall. This lies above these metal rods. Okay, so let's bring in a single vertex and I will snap it right here. Now I will extrude this and snap it right here. Extrude it again and I will finally extrude this and snap it onto this vertex. Okay, so now I will select all of these vertices and I will extrude them in Z direction by 1 meter. Okay, now I will snap this up to this wall. As you can see that these metal rods, they lie below this wall. Okay, let me select these 4 edges and I will press F to fill in. We have modeled the wall and the metal rods. Okay. So now what I will do is I will go into top view. Let's bring in a single vertex and I will snap it over there. Okay. So first let me just hide this wall and let me select this single vertex. Okay, so I will select this vertex and I will extrude it to model the frame of my window. Extrude it and then snap it. Okay. Let's unhide my wall, select all of its vertices and extrude this into Z direction up to this point. Okay. Yeah. Okay. So now what I will do is I will go into the face selection mode and I will select this face and this face. And now I will insert my faces to about 0.05 meters, I guess. Yeah. Okay, let's delete these faces. Now I will isolate this frame to have a better look. And I will press F, fill in these edges. Okay, so I have filled in all the edges. Let me just first disable this auto snapping. So now what I will do is I will create a loop cut inside this frame. Okay. Yeah. Now I will separate this by selection. I will select this loop cut, go into edit mode, select all of the edges and press F to fill in to make the glass. Okay. Select this glass and this frame. I will press Shift D and X and I will snap it right here. Okay. Yeah. Okay, so this one is actually not the same. It actually consists of two frames. Okay, so what I will do is select this glass, press Shift D and X to snap it right here. And now let me just align GX, snap it right here. And snap it below. Now I'll select the upper vertices and snap it at the top. Okay, yeah. Select this. I will make a loop cut inside this mesh. And now I will bevel it to about 0.025 meters, I guess. Yeah. I will deal with the gap later, okay? So yeah, let's delete this face. And now what I will do is select this one. Control L, delete all of these faces. So when this frame is ready, we will just copy and place it where it should be, okay? Let's go into the top view. Select all of its vertices and snap it right here. Extrude and snap it right here. And now let's select this face and select this face. Let's insert this by 0.05 meters. Okay, so let's select this face. And now I will select this face as well and I will just delete them. Select this edge and press F. Select this edge and this edge and I will press F. Let's isolate this one. And I will fill in these faces. Let's first disable the snapping. And let's create a loop cut inside this frame. Press P to separate to selection. And now let me just select this edge, select all of the edges and press F. Okay, so we have the glass and the frame both ready. Now what I will do is select both of these, press Shift D and X. And first let me just enable snapping and I will move this and place it right here, okay. So now as you can see that we have a little bit of gap in between these two doors. We don't want that. To solve this problem, what we will do is, let me just first select this wall. I'll go into edit mode and let's create a loop cut. Okay, and place it somewhere around here. Let's create another loop cut and place it somewhere around here. Right by this frame and this frame. Okay, so let's create a loop cut in between these two loop cuts. Yes. Okay, so now what I will do is select this frame and this glass. Select these vertices and snap. And similarly, I will select this frame and this glass. Go into edit mode. And I'll press GX and snap it right here. Okay. Okay, so yeah. Let's now move on to the bedroom side. Now we will model these bedroom windows. Let's go into the top view. Let's press Q and add a single vertex. I will press G and now I will extrude them. Model my window extrude and snap. Okay, so what I will do is select all of these vertices, extrude them up to this wall. Okay, let's go into face selection, select these two faces, and I will press insert by pressing I, and I will press 0.05. And now I will delete these two faces. Okay, yeah, let's isolate this one. Let's select these two edges and press F. Select these two and press F. Okay. So now what I will do is I will create a loop cut inside this frame. But before that, let me disable the snapping. Okay, so let's separate this by selection. Select all of these edges and press F. Okay, yeah. Okay, so now I will just select this glass and this frame and I will create a copy. Let me before just enable the snapping. Now I will select these two, create another copy, Shift D, X. Let me go into the edit mode, select all of these, rotate them 90 degrees along Z axis. Okay. Press G and snap right there. Let me select these two vertices. I will press GX and now, and let's just snap it to where it should be. Okay. So let's select these two. Press Shift D, move along X axis, and I will snap it right here. Let's press Shift D again. Snap it right here. Let's select them again. And I will create another copy. Press Shift D and snap it right here. Okay. Okay, so I think that's it for this lecture. The next lecture is actually a very important one, because in the next lecture, we will optimize the face orientation of our meshes for Unreal Engine. So it is a very important one. So make sure not to miss that one out. Okay. So I'll see you guys in the next lecture.